War India News Hour. Today, let's talk on the vital role that technology has played during the crisis. 8 out of 10 people across the region said technology has helped them get through the virus, and they used the internet for a wide range of reasons. In most of the sectors we looked at, new users made up more than 30% of total, whereas education, groceries and loans saw the biggest jumps. We are learning new ways of fighting and managing such unexpected diseases that can potentially kill millions of people. It is absolutely true that technology cannot prevent the onset of the pandemic. However, it can help prevent the spread, educate, warn, and empower those on the ground to be aware of the situation and noticeably lessen the impact. Today, with converging technologies like mobile, cloud, analytics, robotics, AI, ML, 4G, 5G and high-speed internet, it has become possible to test several innovative approaches to the pandemic response. The pandemic also saw demand and access to digital services to continue to expand beyond Southeast Asia's biggest cities. In Indonesia, Malaysia and Philippines, more than half of the people were not new to digital services than who lived in non-metropolitan areas. This is an encouraging process, given that the urban-rural digital divide is one of the main challenges a report has highlighted over recent years. The biggest disruption we have seen is the changing shape of the regional internet economy. Not surprisingly, e-commerce is growing faster than we could have imagined before the crisis, that is, from $38 billion in value last year to $62 billion this year, and expected to reach $172 billion by 2025. Digital financial services are becoming more important. The average proportion of cash transactions has declined from 48% of the total pre-COVID to 37% post-COVID. A report shows the annual value of total digital payment transactions across Southeast Asia will almost double to $1.2 trillion by 2025. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. Government announces stimulus package of Rs. 29.87 lakh crores, which is 15% of GDP. The Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has listed 12 new measures on November 12th as a part of the stimulus package during the COVID-19 outbreak. The centre announced another stimulus package worth Rs. 2.65 lakh crores as a part of Atmanirbhar Bharat 3.0. This amount includes the production-linked incentive, that is PLI scheme, announced on November 11th. Sitharaman said the economy is seeing strong recovery and COVID-19 active cases are declining. TCS acquires Pramerica Services Prudential. TCS and the New Jersey-based life insurer signs the agreement for the Letterkenny, Ireland-based tech services business. TCS will take on more than 1,500 Pramerica employees. For TCS, Pramerica will bring multi-year services contracts, strategy expertise and a development center in Ireland. Bharti Airtel has hosted the first O-RAN Alliance Plug Fest in India. Bharti Airtel hosted India's first O-RAN, that is Open Radio Access Network Alliance Plug Fest recently. The event was aimed to demonstrate and explain the growing maturity and development of the O-RAN ecosystem in serving the customers and clients with better and new technologies such as the 5G networks. Palo Alto to acquire service management vendor for $800 million deal. Palo Alto Networks is to acquire attack service management vendor Expanse in a $800 million deal. Out of this, $670 million to be paid in cash and stock and approximately $130 million in replacement equity awards, each such amount is subject to adjustment. Post-merger, the Expanse platform will significantly enrich Palo Alto Networks' Cortex product suite and create the ability to stitch together external, internal and threat data to provide organizations with an integrated view of the enterprise. JioMart makes Big Bazaar to breathe with new lease agreements. Future Group's flagship retail chain Big Bazaar got a new lease of life from Reliance Industries, while the ongoing legal battle continues with the e-commerce giant Amazon, where it has challenged Future Group's deal with RIL to sell its retail and wholesale assets to Reliance Retail Ventures for around ₹24,700 crores. RIL's move to bail out Big Bazaar and a purchase order has been signed last week, and goods from Reliance Retail are set to replenish shelves at Big Bazaar stores across India. PUBG Mobile reveals plans of relaunch in India with newer mantra. PUBG Mobile has found out a new battleground and finally revealed its plans for relaunch in India, but players should expect a new tailored experience within the game. PUBG Corporation, creator of PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds, that is PUBG, and subsidiary of South Korea's Krafton Inc., said in a statement. The company also revealed plans to provide a secure gameplay environment along with investments to cultivate local video game, e-sports, entertainment and IT industries. Moonstick botnet targets Oracle WebLogic. A botnet can do many things which are absolutely beyond the thinking of a common man. It is believed that the Moonstick botnet, aka Moonstick, is to be linked from the Chinese origin, has been targeting cloud infrastructure and IoTs for years. It leverages known web application exploits to compromise IoT devices such as routers to mine cryptocurrency. A Moonstick attack executes in multiple stages. The botnet has been designed mainly for funding itself by mining cryptocurrency using open source tools like XMRig and CGMiner. Cisco WebEx and WhatsApp have been warned by CertIn on security vulnerabilities. Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, that is CertIn, has warned that the popular messenger app WhatsApp and Cisco WebEx video call service has vulnerabilities that can enable hackers to steal important user data in phones and PCs. Multiple vulnerabilities have been reported in WhatsApp and WhatsApp Business for iOS, which could allow a remote attacker to bypass security restrictions or execute arbitrary code on the target system, CertIn said in a statement. CertIn has advised the users to update to the latest WhatsApp update and also iPhone users to upgrade to iOS 14.2 immediately. Now onwards, the OTT platforms also to come under government purview. The traditional entertainment industry is going to get its revenue stream out. Now, the OTT platforms including Netflix, Amazon Prime Video, Sony Live, Zee5, Disney Plus Hotstar, among many others, and news websites will now come under the purview of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. Few filmmakers have expressed their disappointment at the government's order. At the same time, many others said they will be looking forward to working with the government in implementing self-regulation code. Tablets and Chromebooks, the new hotspots for growth in the PC market. The total PC market, including tablets, enjoyed a second successive quarter of stellar growth with total shipments of 124.5 million units, up 23% year-on-year. Lenovo led the global market with 23.5 million tablets, notebooks and desktops shipped, followed closely by Apple with 22.1 million Macs and iPads. HP, Dell and Samsung rounded out the top 5. Chromebooks were the best performing client PC product in Q3 as shipments grew 122% at a total of 9.4 million. Detachables, that is tablets and notebooks, grew 88% and were the second best performing category in personal computing. Within desktops, all-in-ones grew 7% despite an overall desktop market decline of 32%. Indeed, technology has advanced and will continue to advance exponentially. But the human institutions and societies need to accelerate in adapting to it and continue investing in building the technology systems for the preparedness. After the COVID-19 outbreak, it is evident that from AI to robotics, the technology innovations are helping to manage the epidemic and better equipped to fight future public health emergencies in a timely, systematic and calm manner. COVID-19 has completely transitioned how content is being generated, distributed and streamed. online streaming of live shows and concerts has gained traction across the world. Several film production companies have also been releasing their movies via over-the-top, that is OTT platforms such as Amazon Prime Video, Hotstar, Netflix, Z5, etc. OTT caters to varied interests of people across the globe with the perennial additions of diverse content. The lockdown has helped people in realizing the ease of viewing content on OTT platforms. It has changed how people are consuming content on a day-to-day basis. Secondly, the online grocery market witnessed tremendous growth during the pandemic due to the soaring demand amongst consumers. All the biggies are gifting, fighting on the streets to gain market share by offering a handful of discounts. The most important transformation we have seen is technology that helps in getting the real-time information on the number of fatalities, diagnosis and treatment options, vaccines, medicines, government policies, etc., that creates more panic and anxiety among the population. In order to reduce false information, companies like Google, Facebook and YouTube are working tirelessly to guide people to the right verifiable information, such as the published by WHO or local authorities and government. Wishing you all a very happy Choti Diwali. With this, let's wind up for the day. But do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. Please download the War India app from Google Play Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.